So in this example, we'll be looking at monode growth kinetics. And the problem statement is that if we wanted to produce a recombinant protein in a coli, once the cell density had reached 400 million cells per liter, how long would we have to wait for us to reach this cell density if we started with an initial inoculation density of 10,000 cells per liter and a glucose concentration of 100 grams per liter? And we know that for E. coli growth on glucose, mu max is 1.3 inverse hours. Ks, the Ks constant, is 2.2 e to the negative 5 grams per liter. The death constant is 0.02 inverse hours. And we're going to assume that one cell is approximately 1 nanogram of cellular mass. So the first thing that we're going to do is write mole balances for the concentration of cells and substrate. So for our cells, we're going to have a change in our concentration of cells over time, since we're in a batch reactor, is going to be equal to the rate of growth of our cells minus the rate of death of our cells. And so for our substrate, the change in the concentration per time will be equal to the negative rate of growth of our cells. And so now second, we're going to define our rate law expressions. And for monode growth kinetics, the rate of growth is equal to mu max times the concentration of substrate times the concentration of cells over the constant Ks plus the concentration of our substrate. And the rate of death is equal to the death constant times the concentration of cells. So third, we need to calculate the concentrations of our cells initially and the desired concentration based off of the mass that we assumed per cell. So our initial cell concentration in grams per liter is going to be the 10,000 cells per liter that we started with times 1 nanogram per cell. And then to get it in grams per liter, we're going to have that 1 gram is 10 to the 9th nanograms. So we're going to have 10 to the negative 6 grams per liter of cells initially. And then the final concentration of our desired cells, also in grams per liter, will be the 400 million cells per liter that we want to reach, times the same 1 nanogram per cell, and 1 gram per 10 to the 9th nanograms. So we want to get to 0.4 grams per liter of cells. So now we can plug in these mole balances for the cells and substrates, and then the rate laws for the growth and death of our cells, as well as the initial concentrations for our cells and substrate, and then vary the time to try and figure out how long it would take us to get to this 0.4 grams per liter of cell. So here's the output from plugging in all of those expressions into polymath, and after varying the time, you can see that the top line of CC, the concentration of our cells' final value, is 0.04, and then the time it took us to get there is the last variable T, which was 8.28 hours.